sometimes a company report a truly terrific quarter, and yet its stock will still go down anyway. Consider the curious case of Shutterstock, SSTK, the online marketplace where businesses of all stripes can license hundreds of millions of high-quality photographs, illustrations, videos, for all you Netflix fans, the opening sequence that you probably love so much in House of Cards, that's one of them. Shutterstock has a vast online library that allows companies, large and small, license the images they need both quickly and legally. Pretty much every business out there needs to use images for something. If only they have a good-looking website, and they have to pay for them or else face a nasty copyright lawsuit. Oh, and 2 months ago, they launched a complimentary music licensing service. This is a rapidly growing company that's aggressively taking share, but it's also a high-flying stock. Which brings me to the quarter. Shutterstock reported yesterday after the close, and to the naked eye, these look like pretty darn good numbers. I thought the stock would shoot up big on it. 3 cent earnings beat off a 22 cent basis. Every line was good. Higher than expected revenues up 41% year over year. Paid downloads up 30%. Strength across every region. Healthy revenue guidance. Yet the stock initially tumbled before recouping some of the early losses. Finished down $2.25, 2.9%. I think a lot of this is simply because Shutterstock had run into the quarter from 67 after the last time it reported to 78 as of yesterday. And this stock has a history of rallying hard, then selling off when it comes over becomes overbought. Currently, though, this is really important. After the dips, Shutterstock tends to bounce right back. And even after today's decline, it's giving you a quick 12% since we last spoke to the CEO 3 months ago. Can it rebound once again? Let's take a close look with John Orringer. He's the founder and chairman and CEO of Shutterstock to hear more about the quarter and his company's prospects. Mr. Orringer, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you, sir. Have a seat. All right, since we saw each other last, deal with Facebook, deal with Salesforce.com and music.
Yep.
These are all needle drivers for next year?
Yeah.
Tell me about it.
The Facebook partnership is pretty important to us.
Yes.
It's an API deal, and just like we integrate into Facebook, we can integrate in other places.
API, you gotta explain that to everybody.
It's an interface that companies can link into to serve images to their customers.
So that's big, and Salesforce is with Exact Target division for?
Yeah, Salesforce is important for our enterprise sales business, our business with big enterprises and larger companies and agencies and stuff like that.
Okay, and music, now who's music and how?
Yeah, so music is important because footage is growing really fast for
us.
Video buyers need music to go along with their footage clips to integrate into their productions. And today it's very difficult, it's very complicated to license music. You can either go to these libraries online that are very small, they're not very sophisticated, or you can go to one of the larger labels, license good music, but it takes a long time and it's very complicated. We're trying to simplify all of this.
All right, so I have a YouTube video that I want to do. It's like a little commercial.
Yep.
And I need music in the background. Just go to Shutterstock to get it?
Yeah, you just go to Shutterstock, you can download. We have 60,000 tracks. We got them from a source that's helping us kind of put together our initial part of the collection. Eventually, we're going to be crowdsourcing this from anyone who wants to contribute.
Well, because, I mean, what I find most interesting is that when I go to most websites now for companies that are on, they have video on and they have pictures on, whereas they would have been flat just like maybe 18 months ago. I'm presuming they're going to Shutterstock for
this
stock.
They're going to us more and more for this.
Right.
We now sell 4 images every second. We have nearly 2 million video clips they can select from. We sold 30 million images in the past quarter alone. So we're increasingly becoming the place that creatives go for all of their creative assets.
Now, why would I go to you instead of Getty?
So we come at this a little differently than Getty. Mm-hmm. We've been doing this for 10 years, and we started with a subscription model. We keep everything incredibly simple. It's one license. Once we negotiate the price point with you from an enterprise sales point of view, or you get to the website and you choose a plan, everything is available under the same exact price point. So it's simple, the license is clear, and you can use our stuff royalty free.
Okay, which brings me back to a pricing situation that I don't understand. Did House of Cards just get lucky in the sense that they went to you, and if I had known how beautiful that opening is every time, I might have said that might have cost hundreds of thousands of dollars to shoot those pictures?
So our contributors understand that this is a volume game, and we've been doing this for a long time. So for every, you know, once in a while, House of Cards will use a clip.
Right.
There are thousands of YouTube videos that are using the clip also. They know that it's a blended rate, and our contributors look at their returns as a return per clip or a return per image over the lifespan of a year. So over time, we've gotten them to understand that there's going to be a lot of times this thing will sell. Sometimes it's going to be used for big cases, sometimes for small, but at a blended rate, you're going to do well.
But why shouldn't some people, why shouldn't Disney pay 5 times more than I would pay?
Because the buyers don't want to deal with the complexity of a rights managed situation. That's exactly why they're not going to some of the companies that they were going to before and increasingly coming to Shutterstock.
Okay, so when you say total customer count exceeds 1 million, that means 1 million people are registered, they're subscribers. So that's a huge number.
1 million people are buying. We have millions and millions more accounts. Yeah, but it's over the, you know, over the recent history of the company, there are 1 million buyers. We measure it in terms of past, like, year or so.
Do you do anything with sports?
Yeah. So anyone who wants to go shoot sports can also sell it through Shutterstock. We have an increasingly growing editorial collection of sports, entertainment.
But who has the rights to that?
So it gets a little complicated. Right. But generally, you know, it depends what sport event you're at.
Well, I mean, the NFL, I know you can't do it, right? They'll find some way to stop you.
Yeah. But this is what we believe will change over the next figure 10 years, right? As more and more people are bringing these high-powered cameras into stadiums.
Right.
And the thousands and thousands of pictures that are getting taken in these places, eventually what's going to happen is some of this stuff is going to start getting tested. It's never been tested before. And
we believe... Tested by who?
Tested by the legal system.
Yeah, see, I think so too, because what I was thinking when I went through this was, I've got great pictures of sport, of people in uniform. And I want to send them to Shutterstock and make some money off of them. I don't want to get in trouble with the league. I figured maybe you guys would figure out, but how long can the league pretend that there aren't people like me out there? Because we all have fabulous cameras now.
Yeah. So this is all going to change over time, believe, right? So when everyone in the stadium has a camera that's powerful enough to shoot this stuff, we're going to figure out how to work with the stadiums and get this stuff out there. Today, we don't sell a lot of that stuff because it is very complicated, but we're here to make it easier.
Well, it is an amazing company, and I know that when I saw you had the music, I said, geez, that's exactly... I'm so afraid of rights, and I'm so afraid of getting in trouble.
It's complicated.
But if I go to Shutterstock, I know I can't get in trouble, which, frankly, is the default way to do it. I don't have to hire a lawyer to be able to have music in pictures.
That's
stuff. It's great quarter. I think it comes right back. That's John Oringer, CEO of Shutterstock. These kinds of stocks are back in vogue. We had a period from March till June. They were struggling. They're not struggling anymore. After the break, I'll try to make more money.